So hello and welcome to our special live coverage of amazing Xinjiang with CGTN. I'm Zhang Meng, and this is our producer as well as a music lover, Xu Zhaoqun.
I believe everybody is a music lover.
Because we are at the Tacheng Accordion Museum now. And join us today are the accordionist Da Wuran and the museum guide Baile.
Okay.
Please come over and
你好
nice to meet you. Audiences.
你好。
跟网友们打个招呼呗。
好，大家好。
Okay, they're saying hello to you.
Okay, so this is actually the fifth day of our journey, and we have now arrived at Tacheng City, northwestern part of China's Xinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region.
So,
what's the first impression of Tacheng?
Oh, what a difficult question, because, you know, this is my first time in Tacheng, and we have just arrived in the city. In the last 2 or 3 hours, the only thing I do is having lunch, and then this is the very first place I visited in this trip. But I believe this is an amazing place, and I believe everybody will fall in love with this sort of place at the first sight. And I'm so eager to have the performance of the accordionist, that Hazak gentleman who's sitting there preparing his performance.
Right. And I guess later you may find the pace of life here a bit laid back, because when it comes to parties between families and friends, it's all about singing and dancing. So it's no surprising that there's a museum in the city that featuring the largest number and the most diverse selection of accordions in the country.
Yes. And I think I'm very lucky today to have this show together with our host of the museum, because, you know, when I was a child, I didn't have the conditions to buy. My family didn't have, it was not rich enough to buy me any music instrument like this, which is very expensive. But now, I think today I can enjoy their play in a very close distance, and I will enjoy that very much.
Okay, so today we are going to take you guys a tour around the public museum here, and let's get started.
Shall we start the tour? Yes. Thank you.
那手风琴呢，通常是分为四个种类的，它主要呢就是有这个全音阶的、半音阶的，还有键钮式、还有键盘式的手风琴。
Okay, so there are four kinds of major kinds of accordions.
Right, including the whole scale accordion, the semi whole scale.
Okay, can you let us know which one is whole scale, which one is semi scale? 哪个是全音阶，哪个是半音阶？
啊，像这个呢，就是全音阶的手风琴，全是黑键，您可以看一下。像这个呢，就是说是半音阶的手风琴，它这个呢，就是说是。白键和黑键都是健全的。
All right, so this is the whole scale, this is the half scale.
是的。
The lady told me the difference only from the appearances. Well, I don't want to waste time to dig into that, to see how it differs from one another. I think we'll spare some time for so many exhibits,
yeah.
Okay?
Right, so basically we're going to have to introduce you guys about six sections in the museum, including Russia, German, Italy, Ukraine, the Republic of
Belarus,
and of course, yes. China.
Of course, China, yes.
And so don't forget to leave your comments and questions on our social media platforms, including our app, YouTube, CGTN's Weibo, and Twitter. Right?
Yeah.
So just if you are interested in any of these instruments, and please leave your comments and questions there. We will try our best to give
you
the answers.
I'm not able to answer those questions.
But we have a guy here, so.
Yes.
Don't worry.
网友们会提问，然后你给他们回答问题。
Okay.
Okay.
没问题。
She is responsible to answer those questions.
Right. So we'll start with Russian area.
Okay. Great. Are these all from Russia? These 这些都是俄国来的琴吗？
是的，都是俄罗斯的手风琴。
这是俄罗斯的还是是有俄罗斯时代的还是是沙皇时代的还是苏联时代的？
多个时代的都有，基本上它的主要它的产地国家嘛就是俄罗斯。
Okay, they're from different period, from Russian period, they're from the South period, and also from the Soviet Union period. Okay.
And
yeah, this one. Oh, this one looks a bit different from those, huh? It's quite square shape. 就是一个方形的琴。
是的，像这架手风琴，其实它就是一个纯手工打造的手风琴。你可以看一下它的花纹，非常的细致，非常的好看。但这个呢，就是用贝壳打磨镶嵌于琴身的。
Okay.
So it's polished by shears, right?
Yes. So the lady at the Bali told me that it's all handmade and. The beautiful patterns and designs are very special from those we have seen previously. And you know, the shells are these wide part on the shell of the on the surface of the accordion are made of shell, 就是 seashell 是贝壳做的，是吧？
是的。
是贝壳做，好，真的漂亮。Okay.
So,
那手风琴呢是分为左半琴身、右半琴身、皮风箱三个结构，它是通过这个皮风箱的来回伸缩产生强大的气流，促使小簧框内的簧片正常发出声音。老师可以看一下咱们这架琴呢，像这个呢就是说是无论是外形还是工作原理都跟我们作践的口琴是一样的，在口琴当中呢就是用嘴巴去吹气，但是在这个手风琴当中呢这个皮风箱代替我们的嘴去吹气，同样能够演奏出优美动听的音乐。
So this handmade accordion actually represents the basic three component parts of a accordion, which include the left side, the right side, and the leather bellow here. So that's just the basic structure of an accordion. So now...
Нет, нет, нарвись Так недороги, Новым московные вечера. Thank you.
So I believe the Russians are all skilled at singing and dancing, right? That's
yes, definitely. And their music are very good. You know, my mom and my dad, they learned a lot of Russian music. The Soviet music in the 1950s and 60s when the two countries were in a very good term. And right. They left me a lot of music books so that I could learn from that book how to sing in the Russian side when I was a small child. So I'm very familiar with that music.
Yeah, I enjoyed it a lot.
Yes. Mm. Okay, so shall we go on?
Yeah, now we are...
咱这架手风琴截至目前是有100年历史的，我们可以看一下它中间这一侧呢镶嵌的钻石。
Okay, okay, 100. This accordion was just made 100 about 100 years ago, in 1920s and 1940s. Yes, yes, it's made in Italy.
它的中间这一侧呢是镶嵌的钻石，啊，两边的按钮呢？
The shining point on the surface of the accordion is they're diamonds. They're diamonds.
Yeah.
Okay.
I like diamonds.
I believe you like that.
My favorite.
它的两边呢也都是用贝壳打磨的。Okay.
Okay. The patterns on the two sides are also made of seashells.
当时要有非常的有钱，或者说是非常的这个有经济实力和社会地位的人才能够拿到这样一架琴。哦。普通人是拿不到的。Okay.
The upper class, the rich people, and the people with the high social status. Would be able to get an accordion like this. Do you know how expensive it can be in 1920s and 40s?
有多贵啊？那当时当时有多贵？当时的话是可以说是，嗯，你也不知道。这个现在的话是无价了。当时的话就是说是光有钱还不行，你必须有这个社会地位，你还得有钱才能拿上这架琴。你是指在中国还是在意大利？意大利，在意大利啊。Even
in Italy, you wouldn't get an accordion like this. Even if you're very rich, you have to have a high social status. Okay, 就是要有社会地位才可以。是的。 Thank you. 谢谢。 All right.
Now we have arriving at the Italian section here.
Oh, the Italian side.
So, what's so special about this country and its accordions?
对这个意大利部分是大概有什么特点？像意大利呢，是它是全世界手风琴制造和出口的大国。大家一起看呢，它非常华丽。那么像意大利的话呢，它是私人定制，非常的人性化的一个国家。像我们可以看一下这边呢，像这家
Italy has become the largest manufacturing and exporting country for accordions, and it actually has a customized design for accordions for men and women, young and old. So,
men and women, young and old, so they have different designs for different people.
是的，像这架手风琴，我们可以看一下这架手风琴，像这架手风琴是一款女士琴。 专门是针对于咱们女性的一架手风琴，非常的好看。Okay,
that looks beautiful. That one is made for women.
我们还可以看一下这边，这边这架黄色件的琴，我们可以看到它闪闪发光。像这架呢，就是专门针对于婚礼的婚礼琴。针对什么？婚礼。哦。That
one is designed for wedding ceremony, so it looks very much more beautiful than other one. It's golden, the golden color. I think it should be white, maybe 100 years ago. So white and gold, pure and prosperous.
Can I actually try it out?
Yes. Yeah, you better try one. 可以试一下吗？可以吗？
这个琴。好。谢谢。 Actually reminds me, because I have been learning the piano since I was young, since five. So when I look at the keyboard,
at
kind of remind me when I was so struggled to, you know, to spend hours and hours in front of a piano and practicing. But now I'd like to try
the new one.
We're going to try out the happy birthday song.
Happy birthday song, yes.
See if I can do it.
Yes.
I didn't know. It's kind of heavy.
Yes.
You know.
Yes.
How
heavy is it? 这个有多重啊？这个？
5公斤呗。5公斤,
5 kilo. 5 kilo. But this one is made for women. Do you have anyone made for men? 有男人拉得琴吗？
女士琴。
这就是女士琴。 男士琴是什么样的？
男士的琴在。
在那边啊？
在这边。
OK. I won't try that.
So, now I do have a question for our followers online. So, which country produced the very first official accordion in the world?
Okay.
If you guys have any idea, stay tuned with us for the answers.
Is it Italy? Okay, you won't let me know.
I don't think so.
You won't let me know, okay.
Okay.
Anyway, it is not China.
No.
No, no. But we do have a lot of very good musical instruments, you know, inherited from our ancestors in the last 1,000 years. But it looks quite different from those ones. Okay, right. Let's continue with this one. Oh, this one is quite old.
No, we have.
It's from Germany. No? It's from Germany. Yes, it was made about 130 or 40 years ago.
140多年前做的，是的，是的。像这架手风琴呢，就是德国霍纳维也纳的一款第一代的典型的琴。那么，在咱们这个全世界的手风琴当中，霍纳是它的牌子是吧？是的，是的。也是它的作者，也就是它的制造商。是的，是的。霍纳先生自己创建的这样一个霍纳品牌。I
see, I see. So this is the brand of this accordion is Hona, which is also the name of the maker of the accordion.
1822年，全球第一架手风琴呢就诞生在德国。
So now we have the answer that in 1822, German has produced the very first accordion in the world. So if you guys guess it right.
Is this one a whole scale or half or a semi-scale accordion?
Among the four main kinds of...
Yes, yes.
Just...
这个是哪一种啊？这个是全音阶、半音阶还是？像当时的话是，这是一阶，全音阶的手风琴。全音阶，全音阶，全音阶。Thank you。那么进入到咱们中国的第一架手风琴呢，其实就是咱们这个德国霍纳牌的手风琴。
The brand of Hona is also the very first brand that came to China.
Do you know when was that? 什么时候？大概是什么年代？年代的话是咱们现在就说是最初中国是应该就是在，咱们1950年左右。 1950 after the founding of the People's Republic.
这个时候咱们的中国才开始接受了这个手风琴这一块的熏陶。 才开始慢慢的启蒙。在之前，其实大家都不太了解手风琴。是的，是的。
Okay, before 1950s, Chinese people were not very familiar with such kind of with these kind of musical instrument with the accordions. Yes, yes. But piano was a bit earlier. It was much earlier. 就是钢琴进入到中国是更早的。
是的，是的，钢琴是相对来说是要比咱们这个手风琴要早的很多。
要早很 ，yes, yes. Piano was much earlier than accordion entering China.
No wonder I had a chance to learn to play the piano back then, but not accordions.
Yes.
现在可以让大家体验一下这个霍纳手风琴的音色。
霍纳手风琴 ，Okay, that one is a real horn.
是的，
是的。Okay.
Well,
I didn't expect to see you in this museum because you are the main actor. I'm just a music
lover.
Thank you very much. And can you tell me what is the name of the first song, the first music before this one, before the 小白杨？就是第一个曲子拉的那个是个什么曲子？
是那个他生的塔塔族的一个四年。
是塔塔尔族的一个民族的曲子
哈。第二个曲说呢，它是榆明县的一个小白杨。
Okay. The first music, the first song is a local song. It's a local song of Tacheng. From the ethnic, what the ethnic groups are called Tatar.
Tatar.
The second one is also a popular song in modern China, which tells the story of Yang Shu.
Yang Shu.
Yang Shu. Yes, a little tree on the border, and actually it tells the story of a young soldier, staying on the border as a guard.For many years and growing together with that little tree, his feeling of missing hometown, his mother, his family. Anyway, it's a beautiful song. Thank you very much.
That's,
谢谢啊，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢。
That's Yuming County, right?
Yes, yes, Yuming County. Yes, in Yuming County, where the 小白杨 grows.
Right. So, as you've mentioned, as a border city in China's far west, Tacheng City has multiple cultural backgrounds.
Yes.
Right, in terms of.
Yes. Yes. How many ethnic groups do they have?
I'm not sure, but they have the most number of Kazakh communities, I believe.
Kazakh,
right, compared with others.
Yes. Yes. Yes.Okay, shall we
continue our journey?
Yes.
听说这是一个镇馆之宝。
是的。那我有一个问题，大家可以看一下，这总共有几架琴
？So, how many accordions?
How many accordions
are there?
they're inside this box, this glass box. Okay, let me make a guess. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
No? 错了.
No. Let me
try it again.
Let me try again. Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Is that one? I believe that is not a separate one from like what we see, what we saw just now. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
对，六个在一起。
OK，OK，OK，six.
那么像这样，为什么这么小呢？看起来。
Yeah, they are so small.
其实您看到的这些手风琴都是近代的手风琴，后来的手风琴，这才是最初的手风琴的样子。
I see.
对，这总共有六架琴呢，均为法国工匠比松所制。那么，他们呢是被称之为了。我们的这个镇馆之宝，总共是有六架。那中间这一架呢，它非常的珍贵，在1866年的时候有所维修过。
Okay.
那他们的所拥有者呢，就是咱们这个图片上的人。
Okay, so there are altogether 6 accordions inside this glass box,
made by French craftsmen.
Yes, that one is a Frenchman.
Huh? Yeah.
Okay,
that's him.
And.Do you think he is playing one of these on the photo? 他在照片上是弹琴的姿态吗？是弹
的
吗？
是
的，
是的，
就是弹琴的。
啊、是。
啊，这个琴也是像这样弹法，他怎么样弹？
他就是跟图片上一样，放在膝盖上弹的。我们最初的这些手风琴都没有这个背带，
哦、
我们会发现啊、
哦，
都是放到膝盖上去拉的。
I see. So this is also a small accordions which can be.Played and put on the thighs.
On the thighs.
Mm.
That's how they used to play the instrument back then.
Mm-hmm.
So that's without bells.
So these are the keys, huh? Are these the keys? So my fingers, when, if I play that one, I should put the keys on, I should put my finger on these keys. So 我手指头应该是按在这上的，
是的，
是
的，是
吧？
是的。还是跟我们现在的手风琴是一样的，也是按在这个上面，
也是按在这上的、
哎、
啊，就是放在这儿，然后这样，
只是放在膝盖上演奏，
放在膝盖上演奏。
对
，OK。
You are so talented.
Thank you.
So now we have arrived.
Yes,
at
Ukraine
section here.
Yes.
乌克兰展区是最特别的地方是什么呀？
我们现在来到乌克兰展区。如果乌克兰最特别的呢，我可以说的是咱们这个乌克兰展区，我们有一个独一无二的一架琴，它跟我们任何馆里面任何一架琴都是不一样的。
哦，我们
可以看一下在这
边
，very distinguished one， which is different。
可以看一下有什么不同。
You ask another question.Let me make a guess. Different from accordion. Less key. That one, we have so many keys, but there are less keys on this accordion. So
yeah,
less key and square shape. I don't know.I cannot see through it. Sorry, it's your turn to answer questions.
其实刚已经说了。
How about the sound?
刚说到一半了。
是不是声音听起来有什么不同？
是声音的问题吗？
是的，声音听起来有什么不同？
Right, okay,
并且我们发现，您刚刚说到了，咱们都是一样的，但是其实得有这个贝斯机。
Yes.
看到了吗？这个都有，但是它呢没有。
All right. Okay.
他也就是说和弦他是没有的，因为他自己就拥有一款非常有特色的低音。他被称之为了灵魂性的乐器。
Yes, the low pitch.
为什么叫做灵魂性的乐器？在乐队当中，他的低音属于他的灵魂，而这架琴就拥有一款非常有特色的低音。
It's so special because it has the low pitch sound, which is different from other instruments and also, the low pitch has been playing the essential role in the band. That's why we can call it a soul accordion compared with others.
I've seen another very interesting one. That one. Is that an accordion as well? It looks, it looks also very different from all the other.
Accordion, yes.
像这架手风琴呢，这也是一架手风琴。像这架手风琴是塔城市本土音乐人乌拉尔自己去创作的一部手风琴。为了庆祝
China, it's made in China.
Yeah, 为了庆祝咱们新疆维吾尔自治区成立60周年和琴在塔城千人演奏会的献礼工程，这架琴是可以正常演奏的，需要2到3个人同时演奏。
All right. This accordion is made by Ural. Is that my pronunciation
咱们塔城人
correct? Okay.就我发音对吗？
啊，对，
是这样吗？
乌拉尔，
你用你的
乌拉尔
、okay. It's made by Ural to celebrate for the celebration of the 60th anniversary of the autonomous region,
it has
a length of 1.35 meters, and it is made in 2 months, and it is made of the components from 4.Accordions. So far, this is the largest accordion in China.
That's why it needs 2 to 3 people to play such a
big accordion. Oh, yes, 2 to 3 people to play together.
Right.
Okay.
Which?
All right. I hope I can join them.
Yeah. But for now, we can have the mini size
I'm very small
of the accordion.
The last song is also a very popular song in 1950s in China, which came from the Soviet Union. It's called the Song of Katyusha.
There's a movie which has the same.
In Chinese, a silent morning, yes, it can be translated from the Chinese name, a silent morning. The music in that film is Katyusha.
That's actually a collective memory among a generation of in China.
Yes. But I believe it is a very good song because it has been tested by time, and it is popular in 1950s, 60s, 70s, 80s, and now I believe that many younger generations, the people of the younger generation, still are very fond of that song.
Right, yes. They're getting to know.
Yeah, okay. Which part of the exhibition
the
are
Republic
we?
Of Belarus.
Belarus.
So what's so special?
All these countries are, all the people in this country are music lovers. They're very good at music.
Right.
Okay.
白俄罗斯就是主要就是非常的漂亮，这个皮风箱打开就像孔雀开屏。
Okay. It's just like the tail of a peacock.
Right, and a piece of artwork,
which is a combination
of both art and painting.
Yes,
here we are. Finally, I'll China section here.
Ah, yes, yes. Finally, the Chinese accordion exhibition area. Huh. Yes, yes. Yes, I'm very familiar. Yes, at least I've seen a lot of, many times, these kind of accordions in my childhood, because, yes, accordion is very, very many years ago, decades ago, when China was in a very special time and people didn't have much to entertain themselves. And accordion is one of the very few musical instruments. Okay. Yes, very few choice to... China.
But you can visit, you can take time, yes, and visit here if you have a chance.
Yes.
So we have seen the heaviest, the largest,
yes. Yes.
The oldest,
yes,
and the, as well as a mini,
yes,
accordions.
Yes, it's
so
just
far.
Small like this one.
Right, it's yes, so cute.
It's quite cute, yes.
Right, so we are going to wrap up today's live stream,
yes,
and thank you so much for your guys' contribution, your time, and your input to with our live streaming.
Yes.
So,
thank you very much for joining us.
And our journey are still to be continued,
yes,
as we are going to travel along from the north to the southern part of Xinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region.
Yes.
So,
still 20 more days trip is waiting ahead.
Oh,
it's a long journey.
Journey.
It's a long, yeah, journey.
But stay tuned with us. And thank you. And
okay,
bye for now.
Bye for now. Thank you.